Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 10.4, Problem 1. This is Section 10.4, Problem Number 1. It says a sociology professor at BCC is curious about whether the student population is 50% male and 50% female, or if it's different. The professor observed 56 female students in a sample of 100 randomly selected BCC students. Test the claim that the student population at BCC is different than 50% female. Use a 10% level of significance. So this is a hypothesis test. So step one is write the null hypothesis. So the symbol for null hypothesis is a capital H with a subscript of 0. Now typically in the null hypothesis you have the symbol mu for population average or population mean, but we are testing a population proportion, so it'll be P, and the null hypothesis always has the condition of equality. So it could be an equal to, a less than or equal to, or a greater than or equal to, but it will have the condition of equality in it somewhere. And what we want to test is that the proportion is 50%, but we need to write that as a decimal. So it's 0.50, or just 0.5. You don't really need the zero on the end. You can put it, certainly, if you like. So that's step one. We've written the null hypothesis. Step two is write the alternate hypothesis. So you're going to have capital H subscript of 1, P, the same number. So if it was 0.5 in the null, it'll be 0.5 in the alternate. But you're going to have a different symbol other than equal. It'll be either less than, could be greater than, or it could be not equal to. So in this case, it'll be not equal to because we want to test that the sample is different, the population rather, is different than 0.5. So not equal to. Now, what type of test is this if we have this type of alternate hypothesis? Again, what are our options? It could be a left-tail test, right-tail test, or two-tail test. And the way you tell is by looking at the alternate hypothesis. And if you have a not equal to in your alternate hypothesis, it will always be a two-tail test. So with two-tail tests, you have a critical region on each end of your graph. And let me just write underneath two-tail. Now, we are testing the claim at a 10% level of significance. So you split that 10% into 5% on the small end and 5% on the big end, or the left end and the right end. So that's our two-tail test. So the next step, step four, is calculate the value for z. So you will have z equals, and now for a test of proportion, it is x, the observed number of successes, minus n times p, and it's your sample size, p is your proportion that you're testing, over the square root of n times p times 1 minus p. That's what we're going to compute. That's our value for z. So z equals x, the observed number of successes. If we read the question, it'll say that the professor observed 56 female students. Minus n. N is the size of the sample, so our sample has a size of 100. That's the value of n. Times p, the proportion that we're testing is 0.5 or 0.50. Again, you can put the zero on the end for a decimal, it doesn't matter. And in the denominator, you will have the square root of n times p times 1 minus p. So again, n, the size of the sample, is 100. It's given in the question. P, again, the proportion is 0.5, which can be written as 0.50 if you like. And then 1 minus p, so 1 minus 0.5. So that's what we will compute. So let's work down some of the numbers. So I have z equals 56 minus 100 times 0.5, well, half of 100 is 50, and under the square root we'll have, well, let's write it out, 100 times 0.5. Now 1 minus 0.5 in the second set of parentheses here is going to give me another 0.5. 1 minus 0.5 is 0.5. So now, let's make a little more progress. Z equals, in the numerator, 56 minus 50 is positive 6. Again, you need to really pay attention to the sign, positive and negative. It's positive 6. And under the square root, if you multiply out those numbers, it's 25. 100 times 0.5 times 0.5, again, multiplies out to 25. And that's a square root that works fairly nice. So I have 6 over, square root of 25 is 5. 6 over 5. And now with a calculator, you can do that computation. 6 divided by 5 equals, and the calculator will tell you it's 1.2. So that was my fourth step. I calculated Z. I started with a formula, filled in the numbers where they went. I did the math, and I got an answer of 1.2. That's what Z is equal to. So now the next step, step 5, is I want to look up that value of Z in my chart for Z. That's at the end of this homework assignment, the standard normal chart. So to look up something in the standard normal chart, the first thing you want to do is write it so that it has two places after the decimal. So that 1.2 needs to be written as 1.20. Now I have two places after the decimal. Next, what you're going to do is split that number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So the zero that I just put in, I actually have to take it off now. But it's part of the process. And what you're doing is you're trying to figure out what row and what column of that chart you're going to look in. So now, the rightmost digit that you pulled off, you put a 0.0 in front of that. Now, the digits from the left, the 1.2, tell you what row of the chart to look in. Again, positive 1.2, because there's two pages for the chart. You want to make sure you're on the positive page. And the 0, 0 column, which is the far left column. And they will intersect at 0.8849. So that's the fifth step. Look up the value for Z. We looked it up. It's 8849. Now, the final step, step 6, is state your conclusion. And your conclusion will either be reject the null, which means you think the alternate is more likely to be true, or fail to reject the null, where you think the null is more likely to be true. Well, what do you do in this case? Well, this two-tail test, did we go into the leftmost or rightmost 0.05? So we're on the positive part. So for this 0.05, if that's what's left over on the right side here, to come up to that would be 0.95 or 0.9500. Well, what did we get when we looked it up? We got 0.8849. So we did not quite go into the critical region. So since we're not in the critical region, our conclusion would be fail to reject the null hypothesis. So that's saying that we feel it's more likely that the null hypothesis is the true statement. So even though this particular professor found a sample with more women than men, it's not statistically significant enough, that one sample, to make us believe that the overall population is different than 50-50. So my final thing, state your conclusion, it will be fail to reject null hypothesis.